وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Let me start with the first point بإذن الله الكريم, which is تعريف الهمة العالية وما يلحق بها. What does الهمة العالية mean? We have to understand it in order to come with it. So inshallah ta'ala, what I'm going to do is I'm going to first of all define the word الهمة, and then I'm going to define the word العالية, and I'm also going to define both of them together. And if there's any other words related to it that is also used in the Arabic language. The word الهمّة, it's taken from مأخوذة من الهمّي. It's taken from the word الهمّي. The word همّة is taken from the root word, which is الهمّي. والهمّ أصل صحيح. Ibn Manzoor in Lisan al-Arab, he says, والهمة واحدة الهمم. So the word همة is the singular, okay, and the plural is همم in the Arabic language. And what does it mean? والمهمات من الأمور الشدائد المحرقة. It is that moment where the person evolves. It is that peak. قال, he also said, وهم بالشيء يهم هما نواه أراده وعزم عليه. It means he intended it, he willed it, and he came with the conviction, the determination for it. Ibn Faris, he said, والهم ما هممت به وكذلك الهمة. هم, we have that one word, and we have the word هم. هم and هم. The root word is hamma, which I gave previously. You can also say, if you want to, himma, or you can say hamma. Both of the way is something you can say. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, by the way, he says the word al-hammu and al-himma, there's a difference between the two. This is a benefit that I, inshallah ta'ala, would encourage you to all write. He says that Ibn al-Qayyim said, وَالْهِمَّةُ فِعْلَةٌ مِّنَ الْهَمِّ وهو مبدأ الإرادة ولكن خصوها بنهاية الإرادة فالهم مبدأها والهمة نهايتها. Ibn al-Qayyim says that the word الهم is the beginning. When you just at the beginning, when you want something, it's called هم in Arabic. And the word الهمة means what? When you, the ending point, that ending moment is called الهمة. What is the word that we're using here? We're using the word al-himma, which is to push yourself to the end. Fayruz Abadi, he said, al-himmatu ma humma bihi min amrin liyuf'ala, is when you intend to do a particular matter. He said that in his kitab Al-Qamus Al-Muhit, and Ibn al-Qayyim's kalam, you can find it in the kitab Madariju Al-Salikin. Ibn Faris also says, والهمام الملك العظيم الهمة. لذلك the Arabs, they sometimes use the word humam for a king. They say الملك الهمام. Why do they say humam? They mean he's a king that has great aspiration. And some scholars, they say الهمام is السيد السقي الشجاع. It's the king that's generous, they use it for. So now we finish the word الهمة. We know what it means. What does the word العالية mean? العالية is اسم فاعل من الفعل على. It comes from the word على, which is high. The word العالية comes from the the word العالية is اسم فاعل. It comes from the verb على. على means what? Hey, high. ولذلك they say وعلو كل شيء وعلوه وعلوه وعلاوته وعاليه وعاليته أرفعه is something high. وعلى الشيء علويا فهو علي وعلي وتعلى. الأزهري he says وعالية الحجاز أعلاها وأشرفها موضعا. In simple terms, it means high. What do they mean together now? This is what really should be with us, inshallah ta'ala. What does Al-Himmatul Aliyah mean together? It means the following, inshallah. It is An-Niyatul Sadiqah. It is to have a good intention. Wal-Azmatul Jazimah. And it's to have a strong determination. Wal-Iradatul Qawiyyatul Rafi'ah. It is to have a strong will. Wal-Raghbatul Akidah. And it is also to have a strong desire. In what? في التحلي بالفضائل, to adorn yourself with virtue. والتخلي من الرذائل, and to give up and abandon bad traits. Let me repeat that one more time. الهمة العالية is to have good intention. Is النية الصادقة. It's a person who has good intention. والعزمة الجازمة. And it is also to have a strong determination. والإرادة القوية الرفيعة. And it is also to have a strong, unwavering will. والرغبة الأكيدة. And it is also to have a strong desire and conviction. في التحلي بالفضائل, to adorn yourself with virtue. والتخلي من الرذائل. And it is also to give up bad traits. So your good intention and your determination and your strong will and your unwavering conviction, all of that is to achieve two things. Is to adorn yourself with good qualities, good virtues, and it is also to give up bad traits. Brothers and sisters, in the Arabic language, the word al-himma is sometimes ascribed to al-aliya. So you say al-himmatu al-aliya. And sometimes what do you say? You say Al-Himmatul Daniya. Al-Himmatul Daniya is the opposite of Himmatul Aliyah. Everything we just said here, the total opposite of it. Now what I want to speak about, inshallah ta'ala, is another term that is also used, which is Ulul Himmah. Before we said Al-Himmatul Aliyah. But there's also another word used, which is similar, which is عُلُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ. What does عُلُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ mean? Al-Jahid, he mentions it, the Mu'tazili, he gave a good definition in that regard. He said, هُوَ اسْتِصْغَارُ مَا دُونَ النِّهَايَةِ مِنْ مَعَالِي الْأُمُورِ. It is to undermine. It is to belittle. It is to underestimate مَا دُونَ النِّهَايَةِ, anything which is below the ending. Anything below the ending for you is, you undermine it. مِنْ مَعَالِيَ الْأُمُورِ, the high affairs. Ponder here. What he's saying here is, the person who has عُلُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ, he belittles, he undermines anything below the ma'ali al-umur, the high affairs, he belittles it. وَطَلَبُ الْمَرَاتِبِ السَّامِيَةِ. And the person is in the quest and the search of what? The high ranks, the high position. وَاسْتِحْقَارُ مَا يَجُودُ بِهِ الْإِنسَانُ عِنْدَ الْعَطِيَةِ. And the person also, what does he do? He belittles the efforts that he or she is exerting. وَاسْتِخْفَافُ بِأَوْسَاطِ الْأُمُورِ. And the person belittles even the middle affairs. And even if the issue is like half-half, بين بين, nope. Is it معالي الأمور? No, I don't like it. I just want the best. وَطَلَبُ الْغَايَاتِ. The person seeks the final goal. وَالتَّهَوُّنُ بِمَا يَمْلِكُهُ. And the person also belittles, يعني puts down what he has already got. وَبَدْلُهُ مَا يُمْكِنُهُ. And he exerts everything he has. That's what he said. What's also worthy of defining is دُنُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ, which is the opposite of عُلُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ. What does دُنُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ mean? دُنُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ It means ضَعْفُ النَّفْسِ. A person has a weak nafs. The weakness in this person's nafs is so weak that they cannot look for al-maratib al-aliyah, the high levels and the high ranks. They can't. وَقُصُورُ الْأَمَلِ. This person, his desires is very short. Like you hear some people who will just say, I want to go Jannah. That's قُصُور. That shows you don't have high aspiration. What should you ask for? The Prophet told us it. The Prophet was teaching his companions. He said, إِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهِ. If you're going to ask Allah something, فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. The Prophet said this to his companions. If you're going to ask Allah, ask him for Firdaus. Because he was teaching his companions to be what? To have high aspiration. Some people will say, Wallahi, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ هُوَ أُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Anyone who's taken out of the, protected from hellfire and just put into Jannah, that's it. That's all I want. No. You're a mu'min. You're a believer, inshallah. Have high aspiration. You don't just want Jannah. You want the highest level in Jannah. You set yourself that high level. And that's how the Sahabas were nurtured by the Prophet ﷺ. In simple terms, dunuul himma is three things. If you have those three things in you, you have low aspiration. What is it? Itharu da'a. You give precedence to relaxation. I just want to relax. That's one. وَالْرِضَى بِالدُّونِ. And you're content with low things. Below the mark. You're content with that. وَالْقُعُودُ عَنْ مَعَالِيَ الْأُمُورِ. And you sit back from the high affairs. You sit back from it. And watch it come and go. If you have those three, any of those three, then you have دُلُوُ الْهِمَّةِ. Your aspiration is low. Now I'm going to speak about the people when it comes to aspiration. The types of people when it comes to aspiration is four types. And as we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Qur'an, He says, إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Indeed, your efforts are diverse. Allah says that subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people are different when it comes to their efforts. Allah is already telling us that in terms of uluul himma, people are different. They're not the same. إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Indeed, your efforts are diverse. People are different. The types of people when it comes to high aspiration are these four, as Muhammad al-Khadir mentions, rahimahullah ta'ala. The first one is, رَجُلٌ يَشْعُرُ بِأَنَّ فِيهِ الْكِفَايَ لِعَظَائِمِ الْأُمُورِ وَيَجْعَلُ هَذِي الْعَظَائِمِ هِمَّتَهُ. It's a person who feels that they have what it takes to achieve those great things. And not they don't just believe it, they work towards it. They go out there and they look for it. Those are the ones which the poet said, وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ كُنَّ كِبَارًا. If the soul has high aspirations, the poet said, تَعِبَتْ فِي مُرَادِهَا الْأَجْسَامُ. The body struggles to keep up with it. These type of people, they see that they're worthy of achieving those high things. And they work towards it. Those are the ones we call عَظِيمُ الْهِمَّةِ. We call them كَبِيرُ الْهِمَّةِ. We call them Ashabu Himam al-Aliyah. People who have high aspiration. May Allah make us from those people. The second type is Rajulun fihi al-kifayat li'adha'im al-umur. He knows that he has what it takes to have high aspiration. He knows he has it. وَلَكِنَّهُ يَبْخَسُ نَفْسَهُ. وَلَكِنَّهُ يَبْخَسُ نَفْسَهُ. But what does he do? He harms himself. He tricks himself by doing what? He harms himself by seeing that he can do it. He has what it takes. He's got the brain. He's got the energy. He's got the lifestyle, everything. But what does he do? He says, I don't want to struggle. Let me just take this one. This is the total opposite of the first one. He's got sagheerul himma. His aspiration is very low. He's got what it takes to do it, but he doesn't want to go do it. The third type of person is رَجُلُ لَا يَكْفِي لِعَضَائِمِ الْأُمُورِ. A person who knows that he can't do those things. He knows he's not cut for it. وَيُحِسُّ بِهِ. And what he feels بِأَنَّهُ لَا يَسْتَطِعُهَا. He can't do these things. وأنه لم يخلق لأمثالها. And he knows, he says, I was not created for those things. So what does he do? فيجعل همته وسعيه على قدر استعداده. He places his aspiration in that which he knows he can do. He knows he's not cut for those things. He doesn't throw himself into that. This individual, we will say he is a person, a man or a woman who's basirun bi nafsi. He's got insight of himself. Mutawadi'un fi sirati. And he's humble in his biography. بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة ولو ألقى معاذيرة. He doesn't bite more than what he can chew. The fourth one is لا يكفي لأعضائه. He's not cut for any of these things. He knows that he hasn't got it in him. ولكن يتظاهر. But he shows the people. He pretends to the people بأنه قوي عليها. He shows the people, he says, I can do it, that's me. مَخْلُوقٌ لِأَنْ يَحْمِلَ أَثْقَالَ. I was created to carry those burdens. وَهَذَا مَنْ يُسَمُّونَهُ. And that is what the great scholars of Islam call فَخُورٌ. They call this person فَخُور. As Allah said, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحَ. It's a person who's فَخُور, who's متكبر. He's مُتَعَظِّمًا. He just bigs himself than what he really is. Those are the four types of people when it comes to high aspiration. Take time. Think about it. Which category of those four do you think you fall into? I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, a shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.